Hello everybody, it's Nicole of Stargazer Soaps, and I'm going to make kind of a fun soap. I said I wasn't going to soap anymore today. In the last couple of days, I have made so much soap. This is batch number 10. And this soap, let me get this blended really fast. A soap that my girls actually came up with last winter, I think it was. Oops, I almost knocked over my stick blender. It is a candy corn soap. I mean, it's August, a little early to be planning for Halloween, but they've been talking about the soap for a long time. They're out playing, so I thought I would surprise them with it. Put my color in here. This is not going to smell like candy corn. I did a lot of research and I couldn't find a candy corn scent that held in cold process soap. So I am doing caramel. And to me, the caramel that I have is a wonderful caramel, and I mix it a lot of times with other scents and do blends. Caramel is one of my favorite smells in the warmer months, so autumn and winter. So I decided just to do a straight caramel. This. So here goes my fragrance. And I'm going to do this in stages. This is my last spatula because I have done so many loaves. I don't have any soaping dishes left. I'm literally on the last of the bunch. I want this to get a little thick. I don't want it to be watery, but I want it to set up quickly once I have it in the mold. And this caramel will retain its scent. And you know what I think I just did? I think yellow goes on the bottom, doesn't it? I think I need to do the yellow first. Let's pull up a picture on my phone really fast. Sure enough. All right, let's hammer out the yellow really fast. Yikes. I've got to measure the fragrance. Got my lye. Some powders floating in there that I poured but haven't blended yet. And I will, fragrance, where did you go? Oh, and my cream and my sodium lactate. A little pressure, huh? boogie if I have to. Emulsify, add my cream. In here and hope that it sets up before the orange thickens up too much and it's in the bowl. Darn it. I even double checked the colors before I started soaping too. Okay, this is still good. But I need that yellow to thicken up. So I'm gonna pause for a second and get my white ready while I wait. Okay, I think I'm good. So I'm just gonna pour as gently as I can on one end here. Oh, my yellow is moving. Okay. Not what I wanted it to do. Oh well, it'll still be fun, right? It smells yummy. Good thing that was empty. Wipe this off. It, like I said, this is my last spatula. I don't want any orange in my white. Wipe off the edge here. And give me a little bit of a clean line. Went through a lot of paper towels today. Got all of my cloths that I usually use. Are waiting for laundry. All right, let me get this out of the way. Here is my lye solution. I added my titanium dioxide to my lye. Hands. What's happening there? always do it that way, but I did today. Clean off the stick blender. I'm kind of annoyed with myself over the yellow moving there. All right, here we go. In here. Stay. So I did not fragrance the top. Because the fragrance does discolor. Air bubble. Anyway. All right. And I'm just going to pour this thinly. It doesn't seem to be breaking through, but I don't want to tip it again. Tilt it, I mean. Since that didn't work so well. Wasn't set up as much as I would have liked. That's all right, it's candy. Doesn't have to be perfect, right? Well, and it's handmade. Therefore, it's not gonna be perfect. I just get this image of what I want in my head. And when it doesn't turn out that way, I'm disappointed. But when I wing it, which is what I typically do, I'm surprised. Let me get something that I like. About trying to scrape out a little bit more orange or white, but I don't think I can. I do need to give this a minute to set up though before I can texture it, so I will be back. Okay, it's pretty close to being ready. It smells amazing. It smells so good. It's warm and it's not too sweet. It's a warm, buttery, melt in your mouth kind of caramel. It has a lot of different undertones in it. So it's not just straight like brown sugar. I can smell the vanilla. This would probably be a good one for me to do a peach top, but that's just, you know, I did that for a while and it's just not my thing anymore. I just really like doing this. I like the flatter tops. So there's a little bit of height, but more, I want more of a curly definition in this one. Like that. And then I'm just going to dust it with a little bit of glitter. And there you have a caramely candy corn luxury soap. Thanks for watching, and I hope I didn't, I don't know, bore you or stress you out with my franticness there, but we will see how this turns out tomorrow. Don't go anywhere. I'll attach the cutting video right to the back of this one. Okay, here is my caramel candy corn soap. You can see my yellow squish down there a little bit, but it's not bad. So let's see what the inside looks like. Thank you. Mm-hmm. It's pretty hard. This is what I wanted the whole way through, but this is the other end. But that's okay too, because you ever get a bag of candy corn and you notice the colors are not even throughout? So there's a squished end.
Still looks really
squished
pretty.
Piece. Thank you. How does it smell?
It smells really good.
It smells like caramel. I'll be curious to see the caramel scent. There we go. Does discolor. It does turn tan, but it's a fairly light tan, so I'm hoping the yellow retains the yellow. And I can tell that it's darker on the outside than the inside already. The whole house smells like caramel right now. It smells so good. My husband came home yesterday and he said, "Oh, what are you making?" "Oh, that's soap. Nothing you can eat." So all in all, I am pretty happy with this soap.
I like that one.
This one, like I said, my girls came up with this idea last winter. And what do you think? Does it match what you thought it would?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You happy with it?
Yeah.
Excited about it?
Yeah.
Yay. So there is the last piece. This will be cured September 5th, 2014. But I am going to wait and put this up closer to October, since this is going to be a Halloween soap. So look for it in October 2014 on my website at stargazersoaps.com. Thanks for watching.
Bye.